Today I'm gonna try creating a gradual depth of field with a couple of different background effects with the free Snapseed app. This image is a raw DNG file. We have a dedicated develop menu available only when editing DNG files. Here I am gonna increase shadows to recover details from the darker parts. Also structure to add a little texture to the image. I'm gonna save this as a separate copy. For best results, instead of directly blurring the image, I'm gonna start with first removing the subject. We'll try the healing tool to do it. Trying here to make a very precise selection to remove the subject here. Don't need to mind the not so clean healing in the middle, as it will be covered later anyway. Now to make the background blur. With the lens blur filter, changing the filter to linear mode. Coming back to see where exactly the subject is standing and placing the filter just there. Manually decreasing the space where the blur effect is not present. Increasing the transition a little. Trying here to give a gradual depth of field. Also increasing the blurness. Next, I'm gonna add some bright light in the background with curves tool. Lifting the blacks and adding more brightness here. Also adding reds and greens to give an orangish tone to it. The reason why I'm doing this before adding the main subject is to not get this bright light on the subject. Going to the masking screen. Tapping on the stacks icon, view edits, curves and brush. Here with the effect disabled and brush value at 100, zooming out, which gives the brush a soft feather. Tapping around the top left to reveal the effect. Applying it. Now with double exposure tool, adding the earlier saved image and setting the image opacity to 100. Going to the masking screen. Roughly revealing the image. Then zooming in to get a precise selection around the edges. Toggling the eye icon gives a red colored mask. This may take a lot of time as it's a lot of manual work here. Zooming in as much as possible and brushing around the edges to get a fine selection. We'll speed up the video here. Making sure the selection is right. Applying it. Next, to give some facelift to the face, applying a selective filter. Increasing brightness and contrast. You could try the portrait filter too for some nice presets there. Going back and correcting the masking here. Leaving these around for the shadows to remain there. Now for some color grading. Going to the white balance menu. Adding temperature, also decreasing the tint just a little to add some greenish tones. Going to curves. We'll try adding some purplish tones here to the shadows. Just a personal preference. So here's a bright background look. Looks like the main source of light is hitting the background. Going back to the earlier applied curves effect and changing the masking here for a different look. Now to change it to a dark background, resetting the curves. Lifting the blacks a little and darkening the overall image. Adding some turquoise and magenta. Also increasing blue tones for a cooler background. Applying only to the background with masking. Revealing the subject. The light source seems completely changed with an artificial light hitting the subject. Hope you all found this video helpful. Thanks for watching.